Glen Ward from St Vincent's Hospital in Melbourne. I'm just going to tell you a bit about some research that we're presenting today on the Islet transplant program. As you know, islet transplantation has been a successful way of treating patients who have severe recurrent hypoglycemia and type 1 diabetes, in which isolated islets which contain the beta cells that make insulin are transplanted into patients and can produce insulin. And in our group of patients that we're presenting today, in seven cases, these particular patients have all come off insulin treatment, and we wanted to know what the best marker of how long they may be off insulin for was. And we've looked at our data now, and the best indicator we've found has been the first phase insulin response, which is the amount of insulin made in the first 10 minutes after an intravenous glucose challenge, was found to be a very good marker of how long the patients were going to be off insulin. For example, in this group of patients, they were right off insulin therapy for an average of 3.6 years, but with a scatter from a few months to now 10 years. So we have looked at the intravenous glucose tolerance test and found a very significant correlation with how long an individual patient stays off insulin with the amount of insulin made in that first 10 minutes after the intravenous glucose challenge. We think that this is very important because this will give us a tool in order to predict how long an individual patient may be off insulin, and this would allow us to plan when those people require a second transplant or may require no further transplant. So, and that's what we're presenting today.